Son of a 59-year-old man killed in the waters off Lanikai over the weekend. It happened at Saturday at the beach there. Spoke to us at the hospital today for the first time since that harrowing incident. The 25-year-old is still recovering, but he tells us he should be out of the hospital soon. Over the weekend, Trey Albrecht and his stepfather, Shri Shrim, were free diving when a boat hit them both. Alex Herbal follows up tonight. Alex.
Aloha, Howard. Trey was surrounded by his three sisters. They tell me they are coping with losing their father, and they didn't want to talk about what happened on Saturday. Trey says he and his stepdad were doing something they loved, and the family is really grateful for the outpouring of support. With his arm in a brace and a bandage on his leg, Trey Albrecht is moving around connected to an IV. The 25-year-old Kailua man told me about his injuries from a boating accident on Saturday.
The left arm, there's three separate lacerations. I had one near my wrist, one in the center of my forearm, and one by my elbow.
On Wednesday, he and his stepsisters talked about their father, Shri Shim, who was killed Saturday from blunt force and boat propeller injuries, according to the Honolulu Medical Examiner's Office.
I'm extremely, extremely lucky to be alive.
Yes.
Not be in a wheelchair.
Shim was a father, a surfer, and a waterman who was stoked on life. And his daughters laughed, remembering the jokes he used to tell them.
Oh, you're so pretty today. Pretty ugly.
Yeah. Just like...
Were you guys using a dive flag, and have you had a chance to talk to them?
We're not here.
I'm not going to discuss that right now.
Trey tells me the details of that day are still foggy, and right now he wants to focus on his recovery and his family. He also told me that more people should be aware when they are in the water, no matter what the conditions are.
Always, we call it scanning the horizon. So, no matter if it's flat or if it's windy, whenever you're operating some type of machinery like that, you need to always be scanning the horizon.
Still be pretty raw and emotional for him. Now, I reached out to DLNR to ask if the boat operator has been interviewed and if they received proper boat operator training. Now, divers are also required to have a dive flag, and that is also part of the state's investigation. Now, a spokesperson for DLNR tells me the investigation is nearly complete and we should have more details by Friday. I'll keep you posted. Alex Herbal, KHON2 News.
Alex, thank you. We first told you about the press conference via a push alert, and we also streamed it online for you to watch. To get all the breaking news you need right on your phone while you're on the go for free, download our KHON2 mobile app. Make sure to allow for push alerts.